All right, well, welcome back to MLG Championship Sunday, coming to you live from San Diego. Right now we've got Triggers down with a 1-0 lead over Instinct. So far, great action here in this game. The match is not closed over yet. Remember, we've got two more wins left for Triggers down. Instinct trying to stay into it. We're going to get this next one rolling. Let's take a look at the map that they're going to be playing on.
That's right, we're going into Game 2, Team Slayer on Construct. Now this one is going to be fast-paced while we watch players control the Rockets and Sniper for some explosive kills. We're going to be starting this one off once again with Snipe Down, the newest member of Instinct and the newest player to make it to the top three. So Snipe Down going to work early on. He was taken down by Victory X, formerly of Instinct, and now Victory, after picking up that initial kill, is going for the Sniper Rifle. Let's check it out.
All right, well, folks, we got a very special guest up here in the booth with us. He's a great Halo 3 player. He's known as Elamite Warrior. And you know what? He plays on the team called Straight Rippin'. Right now, they're sitting back, sitting pretty, waiting to see who they're going to play. These two teams, very familiar with them. They've got a 3-1 lead and a 3-0 lead, so they're sitting real pretty right now. Elamite, welcome to the booth. It's great to have you.
Thanks.
Now, we've seen you guys go, go against both these teams. Who would you rather face off against in this next round? Who do you expect to come out of this one on top?
I think Triggers Down's probably going to come out on top. Although we 3-0'd them, I think they were the more difficult team to play. Instinct did take a game.
All right, well, giving you a score update, it's 9-8 right now. We have Triggers Down trailing. Victor X trying to go to work here on the Rocket. Victor X is taken down by Roy. Let's hop on board with someone here from TD. We're going to stay on board, actually, with SK now. All right, we're trying to get Elmite suited up here with the headset. In the meantime, 15-13. Triggers Down just won game one. They are up over Instinct. And something to point out here, Sundance, is Instinct has lost 4 of their last 5 games.
Well, that can't leave them feeling very good. You know what? I think we've got the problem solved here. Elamite, are you with us?
I think so.
All right, I can
got
hear
him.
You now. That means we got him. Yahtzee. So think about that. Instinct, they're in a bad place right now. They're on a bit of a losing streak. You guys sent them down. Now they're up against Triggers Down. What do you do if you're Instinct? How do you stay focused? How do you not stop believing in yourself?
Oh, well, right now looking at Triggers Down, it looks like they're just playing on fire. All 4 members are doing really well. So for Instinct, it looks like Fear Itself is there. We're playing the best, so shutting one of those players down is definitely going to be key.
All right, well, now, as I said, you're able to join us up here because you guys did your hard work already. You're sitting pretty, you're waiting, and you've got a lead on both these teams. Now, what are you guys doing to stay from getting overconfident? Because, again, that was the knock on your team going into the Meadowlands. It seemed like everyone expected you to win, including yourselves.
Yeah, that's true. We came into Meadowlands really confident, and unfortunately, we had a really off tournament for all 4 of us. So going between Meadowlands and San Diego, we had a long break, and we watched a lot of the games and realized what we were doing wrong and what the other teams were doing well that worked. And then we landed with Under the Influence, and we won 100-9. So we were pretty confident coming into San Diego,
well,
too.
That's just nasty. I mean, I don't know how those guys didn't eventually leave.
Now, Kyle, you guys are definitely playing much better than you were in Meadowlands, especially you. What did you do to change in between the two events?
Well, I was just realized how, I was watching Legit, T2, and Neighbor play, and they're just all so good. So I decided I'm just going to step up on objective work. And so now it's like Brian and I doing the main objective work, and Tom and Mason slaying. So as long as we have 2 people that are really focused on objective, it seems to be really working well for us.
You know, I don't know if you're aware of this, but I've been talking to some pros on some other top teams and asking them for their list of who's the top 5, top 10. And you know what? You're making it into a lot of top 5s these days. Does that surprise you at all?
I guess I'm a little surprised. I think everyone on our team is pretty equally skilled. Mason's having a great tournament. So is Brian and Tom. So I like to think we're all on the same platform and all not compare us to each other. I just think we're all top players.
I love that answer. I got to be honest with you. Elamite with us. Join us on Championship Sunday here live from San Diego. Saying all the right things. Feeling good. you know what? I love the fact you guys win together, you lose together, but you never ever point fingers, and that's something that you've definitely had going through. Would you say that you guys have formed a strong bond over the last two seasons? What you've been through ups, you've been through downs. It looks like you're back on track for some more ups. Is that part of just being together and believing in each other?
Yeah, I think every team goes through the ups and downs. You know, we have our fair share of arguments, and you know, we just basically come together before each tournament and you know, go in with an open mind and with being confident.
Now, Elma, you guys really broke onto the scene with your victory over Final Boss in Orlando last season. Now, this is going to be your second championship, or your first championship, actually, this season. How are you guys prepared?
Yeah, I think we're prepared. We're just going to keep doing what we've been doing all tournament. Seems to be working pretty well so far. We've only dropped one game, and, you know, we don't want to drop anymore.
Got it. Well, jumping back into this game, it is 44-38. Right now, we have Instinct on top. They have a 6-kill lead, but they're spawning down low with top control, 4 triggers down. So this is going to be a very tough position, but if they can break through just once, they should be able to trade kill enough to the end. You see Snipe down, dropping the shield, but unable to clean it up. Macchio pushes in on Fear itself, who had no shield, so Macchio, after picking up the double kill, is going to give his team the 46-47 lead. Roy and Snipe down still going to work. Sniped out, going up the new lift. Here's Fear itself. There is the 48th kill. Just 2 kills to go now. Sniped down has been on fire all game long, and Instinct is back in it.
And this is exactly what Instinct needed. They had dropped too many games in a row. Now they take this one, 50-43. Macchio giving some pounds, giving out some love. You look at his teammates right there. They're ready to go. They've got to be feeling good on the other side. Triggers down, hoping to build on the momentum of that first game. Not able to do so, but not out of it. So now it's going to be 1-1 in this matchup. Let's take a quick look at the stats.
All right. Well, Roy, ridiculous. Positive 8. 16 kills, 8 deaths, 12 assists. That is the Roy we know and love. His BR was absolutely on fire. On the other side, Hysteria was doing as much as he could. But triggers down, they just couldn't control the top that one.
Well, it definitely looked like Instinct had their way right there. Got to be feeling good, but you know what? It's just 1-1 right now. You look at them. We're getting ready for the next game. But before we go to that next game, I got to say happy Father's Day to all you dads out there. We're going to be right back with the after this quick commercial break.
I guess I have played through this game a couple times. It's not you, it's me.
Look, maybe it's time we both moved on. Sell us back to GameStop. You'll meet new people, we'll meet new people. We'll both be happier. Now come on, one more deathmatch for old time's sake.
Your old games find new life at GameStop. Power to the players.